हेलो चिल्ड्रेंस, गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल। वेलकम टू ऑनलाइन मैथ्स क्लास। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी अबाउट द न्यू लेसन नंबर्स। इन दिस लेसन वी आर गोइंग टू सी अबाउट द न्यू टॉपिक दैट इज डिविजन अप टू फोर डिजिट बाय सिंगल डिजिट नंबर। We are going to divide the four-digit number by single-digit number. To divide a given number by another number in various ways. We know some various ways to divide the number. That one way is equal sharing. Second way is equal grouping. Third way is repeated subtraction. Fourth one is long division. Fifth one is short division. You have learned already the type of division in previous class. Now we are going to see equal sharing and short division. We are going to see about equal sharing and short division. What is equal sharing? Equal sharing means equally divided by each and every number is given. Okay, let's we see the example to do the sum. First one, division of 3-digit number by 1-digit number without remainder. So example 1. Divided 450 by 6. Now we want to know the table of 6. The dividend is 450. 450 is divided by 6. That is a divisor. For in 45, we'll take 1 by 1 number. First we'll take 4. In 4, how many 6 are there? There is no 6 in 4. So I'm going to take the two numbers 45. In 45, how many 6 are there? Yes, there are 7 6. 7 6 are 42. Carry balance 45 minus 42 is 3. So take it down the 0 to down. Now, in 6 table, 30 how many times will come? 5 times. That should be right on the topmost corner. That is quotient portion. So 5 6 are 30. Remainder is 0. Therefore, quotient is equal to 75 and remainder is
0.
Next sum, that is word problem, example 2. A fruit seller buys 531 apples. He arranges them equally in 9 boxes. How many apples does he put in each box? Here, large number is given and the small amount is given. So we want to do the division. So let's we see the solution part. Total number of apples is equal to 531. Number of boxes is equal to 9. Number of apples in each box is equal to 531 divided by 9. Here we want to know the table of 9. In 9, how many 53s are there? Yes, there are 5 9s. 5 9s are 45. So 53 minus 45, which is equal to 8. 8. Then take it down the 1 down. 81. In 81, how many 9s are there? Yes, there are 9 9s. 9 9s are 81. So remainder is equal to 0. The number of apples in each box is equal to 59. Now we will see the example. We completed the example, ma'am. Now we are going to see about exercise. In exercise, I'm going to teach you only the word problem and the small sums and all your homework. Okay, exercise 2.1, question number 7. Rahul has 192 toy cars. He put them equally in 6 boxes. How many toy cars will he put in each box? How many toy cars are left over? Here we left over means we'll get the remainder. So we'll see the answer part. Number of toy cars is 192. Total number of toy cars is 192. He want to put them into 6 boxes. That is, number of boxes is equal to 6. So number of toys in each box is equal to 192 divided by 6. So we want to know the table of 6. In 6 table, how many 19s are there? Yes, there are 3 19s. 3 6 are 18. If you are subtracting 19 minus 18, we will get 1. Take it down the 2 down. Now we have the number 12. 12 means 6 table 12 how many times? Yes, 2 times. So it is 2 6 are 12. That if you are subtracting you will get as 0. So quotient is 32, remainder is 0. Therefore 32 toys in each box and there is no leftover toys in that total number of toy cars. Yes, my dears, did you all understand? Move on to the next question. Question number 8. Akila has 495 photographics to put in an album. She can put 9 photographs on each page. Each page she has to put 9 photographs. So how many pages can she fill? So number of photographs she has is 495. Each photographs she has 9. Each page she has 9 photographs. So 495 divided by 9. 49. How many 9s are there? There are 5 9s. There are 5 9s. 5 9s are 45. So 49 minus 45 which is equal to 4. So take it down the 5 now. So 45, now we have the number 45. Already we learned in 9 table we have 45s. So 5 9s are 45. If you are subtract you will get 0 as a remainder. Therefore the quotient is 55, remainder is 0. So she can fill all the photographs in 55 pages. Now we will see division in 4 digit by 1 digit. 4 digit number divided by 1 digit number. So divide without remainder also. Example 1, 7416 divided by 6. So in 7 how many 6 are there? There is a 1 6 in 7. So 1 6 is 6. If you subtract 7 minus 6 you will get 1 as remainder. Take it down the 4. In 14 how many 6 are there? 2. 4 6 are there. So 2 6 are 12. So 14 minus 12 is 2. Take it down the 1. In 21 how many 6 are there? 3 6 are there. So 3 6 are 18. So 21 minus 18 is balance is 3. 21 minus 18 is 3. Take it down the 6. Now in 36 how many 6 are there? Yes, there are 6 6 in 36. So 36, if you subtract you will get 0 as remainder. So quotient is equal to 1236 and remainder is equal to 0. Yes, my dear, let's move on to the next example. Example 2, 9689 divided by 8. Here we want to know the table of 8. So in 8 table how many 9s are there? There is a 1 8 in 9. So 1 8 is 8. So if you subtract you will get 1 as remainder. Take it down the 6 now. Now we have the number 16. In 16, in 8 table how many 16s are there? 2 8s are in 16. So 2 8s are 16. If you subtract you will get 0 as a remainder. Now take it down the 8 down. 8 we have 1 8 and 8. So in 8 table, so 1 8 is 8. Subtract will get 0. Again take it down the 9. We have 1 8 in 9. So 1 8 is 8. If you subtract you will get 1 as a remainder. It is called with remainder sum. So the quotient is 1211. Remainder is equal to 1. In this example related exercises then exercise 2.2, let's we see the sum now. In my school there are 1115 students from class 1 to 8. If the number of students is same in all the classes, how many students are there in each class? From the question what did you understand? In a school there is a students. In that number of students, we have to divide it into all the classes. Now we want to know what are the classes. Yes, let's we see how many classes in, how many students in each class, what are the number of classes. Okay, so we will take classes 1 to 8. Classes 1 to 8. So if the number of students in same class, all the classes should be same. So 1115 divided by 8. So in 11, how many 8s are there? Only 1 8. So 1 8 is 8. If you subtract, you will get 3 as remainder. Take it down the 1. 31. How many 8s are there? 3 8s are 24. 3 8s are 24. Balance is 7. Take it down the 5 now. So in 75, how many 8s are there? 9 8s are 72. 9 8s are 72. If you subtract, you will guess 3 as remainder. Therefore, in each class, there should be a 139 students. In each class, there should be a 139 students. Let's move on to the next question. Question number 8. The height of the mountain is 7,821 meter. Raj took 9 days to reach the top. How many meters did he cover daily if he traveled equal distance every day? If he traveled equal distance in every day. So the number is 7,821 meter, the height of the mountain. So how many days he is walking? 9 days. So 9 divided by 9. So in 78, how many 9s are there? 8 9s are 72. Subtract, you will get the answer as 6 as the balance. Now take it down the 2. In 62, how many 9s are there? 6. 6 9s are 54. So 62 minus 54 is 8. Take it down the 1. So 81, we have the number as 81. In 81, how many 9s are there? Yes, that is 9 9s in 81. If you subtract, we'll get 0 as remainder. So he traveled 869 meter every day. Every day he traveled 869 meters. Move on to the next question. Question number 9. A total of 1787 kg wheat has to be packed equally in 7 bags. What will be the weight of each bag? So here is total weight of a wheat is 1787 kg, kilogram. So now how many bags we have? 7 bags. So number of bags is equal to 7. So we want to know the table of 7. So in 17, how many 7s are there? 2 7s. 2 7s are 14. Take it down, 17 minus 14 will get 3 as balance. Now take it down the 8. So 38, how many 7s are there? There is a 5 7 in 38. 5 7s are 35. So 38 minus 35, which is equal to 3. Take it down the 7. At last, we will get again 35. 5 7s are 35, balance 2. So each bag's weighs 255 kilo. kg of wheat, and 2 kg wheat will be remaining in that whole wheat bag. Okay, ma'am. Let's we move on to the next exercise 2.3. Here we are going to frame the question with the given values. We are going to frame the question. Okay, so I'm going to directly teach the exercise 2.3. First sum. Here is first serial number. We have raw rice, that is per kg is 56. What is the question we can ask? What is the price of 6 kg boiled rice? Here, 1 kg of raw rice is given, that is 56. So, how many kgs? How many kgs you want, you can ask like that. The same way for wheat. So, here is wheat is 40 rupees per kg. So, I need, what is the price of 2 kg of wheat? What is the price of 2 kg of wheat? Like that. You can ask, you have one more question also, you can ask one more question also like that. What is that is, what is the sum of a price of 6 kg boiled rice and 1 kg raw rice? If you add and get, you will get the answer. But we are not going to do the subtraction, addition and all. We are going to frame the question, that's it. You can make any type of question with the help of like this. Okay, ma. Today's session is completed. Today's homework is exercise 2.1 first 6 sum, exercise 2.2 first 6 sum, and exercise 2.3 last 2 sums. Okay, today's session related to division with 3 digit by 1 digit, 4 digit by 1 digit. Today's session is completed. Thank you.